Friends, I welcome all of you to the session on report writing. We all understand the term report, but different people have different meanings for the word report. We actually are quite familiar with the report right from our childhood. When a small child goes to school and in the evening when he comes back, his mother asks him, how was the school? And she or he will report to the mother that such and such things have happened in the school. You know, like this, we keep on reporting every day in and day out. There can be formal and informal report. There can be oral or written reports, different kinds of report. In the professional field, report writing is a very important aspect. Right from the annual confidential report of the employees to the daily working, especially in the engineering area, the employees, the people who are working at all levels have to report about the progress of the work, how the things are happening to their superiors and sometimes to their juniors also, to their peers also. And one of the traits the industries are looking for when they come for the placement of the students in the campuses, that their ability to write good reports. In this session, we will be talking in details about various aspects related to report writing. I have divided my presentations into these sections. We'll be talking about the meaning of report, types of report, essentials of report writing, 5 W's and 1 H model of report writing, then characteristics of a good report. And in the second session on report writing, we'll be covering structure of a report and format for a progress and lab report. So in the first session, we'll be covering aspects related to meaning, types, essentials, a model, and characteristics of a good report. Let me start with the dictionary meaning of the word report. The word report is derived from the Latin word reportere, which means to carry back. You know the word porter? We are very familiar with that. We find the porters at the railway stations or at the airports. They carry luggage for us. Now, in this case, reportere means a person who carries some information back to somebody. Let me give you a few definitions of the report writing. It is a description of an event carried back to someone who was not present on the scene. You see the people at the television, the reporters, or at the radio at your radios. Or maybe in the newspapers, the reporters are there. They try to report something which has happened to you because you are not there at that site. Okay? And then a report is normally a formal communication. There can be informal reporting also, but usually for our professional purposes, we like to say that it is a formal communication written for a specific purpose. There is always an objective for which the report is written. We'll be talking in details about that. In simple terms, we can say a report is a communication from someone who has some information to someone who wants to use that information. For example, if there is a person who is working in the R&D section of any organization or any industry maybe, he has to report to the persons who are taking decisions based on the experiments he is performing in his lab. So it becomes very essential. The person who has to take a decision may not be actually conducting the experiments. Somebody else is doing the experiments and he is reporting his results to someone who has to take decisions based on the results on those experiments. Likewise, you know, different industries, different professional organizations may be having a reporting system which can be daily reporting, weekly reporting, fortnightly, monthly, biannually, annually. You know, the periodicity of the report may vary. And in some organizations, it becomes so crucial that they want you to report every few minutes. For example, if some incident has happened, let us say some accident has happened or something has happened in a particular place, the television people have to report very frequently. I mean, after every few minutes, they report. Those reports may sound a little bugging to you, but then the people whose relatives are involved in those incidents, for them it becomes very crucial to know about them. Similarly, you know, in many situations you can think about how the report writing is very important. The importance of report as far as our engineers are concerned, our students are concerned, number one, the report writing develops the power, certain traits, it develops certain traits in the student, which are the discrimination. It helps the student to develop analytical abilities. Every report requires certain kind of analysis. So it helps the student to develop those analytical abilities by which they can discriminate different things, which is so very important in the professional field. Then it also helps the student to develop organization abilities. A good report has to be well organized. Then it also helps the students in making decision-making abilities in the student. They are able to make judgments. Every report requires to draw certain inferences. So the students learn how to draw judgments and how to take decisions based on the experiments or other things. Then it also helps the student to how to communicate, both oral as well as written, and many other important traits are developed through report writing, which are very, very essential in the professional areas. Now, different types of reports. We have oral as well as written reports. We are all familiar with the oral reports and also with the written reports. Then there are informal and formal reports. You know, the informal report is also sometimes in many organizations is known as grapevine, which means you are not actually putting everything on record, but you want to communicate that this is what is happening or this is what has happened. So this becomes a very important tool to spread the message or to inform a particular agency or a particular person in an organization using the informal channel. And formal reports we are very well aware of. Then there can be reports which are informational. There can be reports which are interpretive in nature. There can be reports which are routine reports. Each has its own significance. The routine reports, for example, when we talk about informal or maybe routine reports, there can be routine reports which may be overlooked by many, but it is so very significant. For example, the weather reports coming in the newspapers. Sometimes we do not care much about it. But when we have to plan something, for example, there is an event you want to plan, maybe outdoors, then you are very, very careful. It may be a routine report, which you may not, in your routine, you may not give much notice to it. But then on particular occasions, that report becomes very, very important. And it can play a very significant role anyway. For example, I know of a case in an institute where a routine report has brought about significant change in the behavior of the students. I happened to visit that institute and I was taking dinner in one of the students' mess. And as I entered the mess, I saw a small whiteboard. And in that whiteboard, it was mentioned, it was a dinner time, that in the breakfast, how much food was left over by the student after the breakfast was over, and how much food was left over by the students after the lunch. And I asked the person who was supervising the mess, he told me that the amount of leftovers by this simple reporting to the students, a routine report to the students, by this simple reporting, the leftover of the food has decreased from kgs to few grams only. When the students were able to see that how much food we are wasting, simple, nobody is talking to anybody, but they're simply seeing that today we have wasted so much of food, today we have wasted so much of food. Slowly, slowly, they became conscious and they will put that much of food which is required by them in their plates. So a routine report can play a very significant role in bringing about the change in the behavior of individuals. Then there are certain essentials for report writing. We'll be talking in details about that. Number one is issue a perspective. A report should be unbiased. It should be written very objectively and authentically. It should be, for example, if there is a case, some happening has happened in an institute and somebody has to report about it, it will be very unfair to take the opinion of a group only. Let us say something has happened in the college and a newspaper correspondent comes there and he takes the opinion of the students and report it in the newspaper. It is not going to be very fair. He has to see that issue from different perspectives. He has to interview, maybe take the opinion of the authorities as well, and then report that this is what the students say, this is what the authorities says. And this is very important in the report. The issue or the perspectives, perspective of the issue from different angles, from different people, so that it is very authenticated and objective and unbiased. Then second important aspect of the essential of the report writing is, it should be having authoritative facts and figures. When you are giving certain facts, certain figures, it should be counter-checked. It should be cross-verified and also acknowledged that I am taking these facts and figures from so-and-so source. This makes the report more acceptable to the people to whom you are reporting. Then it should have an in-depth analysis, not just a superficial information, but when you are giving certain report, then it should involve in-depth and meticulously analyzed data and related issues, or issues related to that perspective should also be given in the report. Then alternate viewpoints. I have talked about that. Viewpoints from independent of the positions. I mean, since the senior have said so, so that may not be authentic or may be authentic. So independent opinion relevant to the main issue has to be reflected in the report. Alternate viewpoints from various sources. Then appropriate annexures. I always say that communication, the soul of the communication lies in its brevity, being brief. And many times when you write long reports, nobody is interested to read them. In order to avoid the length of the report, in order to being brief in the report, whatever you want to say, facts, figures, and many other things, they can go in the annexure. Let the report be of a very small length of the pages, maybe depending on the contents, of course. All the relevant information, which is not actually the report, can but it is supporting the report, can go in the annexures, and they have to be referred. Somebody who is interested to know those facts and figures may refer to those annexures. Additional information or pertinent to the subject may all go to the annexures. Now I will share with you 5 W's and 1 H model, which is internationally followed by many professional organizations as well as the report writing is concerned. The first W stands for what? What is the problem? Justification. What is the problem? Very clear-cut words, in very clear-cut words, you define what is the problem definition itself. Then why? Why are you reporting? Importance or the objectives? Why? What are the objectives of my writing the report? What it will serve? Then, who are the people involved? The reader, the writer, or maybe third party? Who are the people which concerns the report? For example, we get a newspaper. We all get the newspapers at our home, and we watch television also. Every news is not for everyone. Maybe if I am related to sports, I am working in the area of sports, those relevant things are with me, which are dealing with the sports. If I am dealing with the health, maybe I will like to read the health columns. So who are the people for whom we are writing the report is very important aspect. And then when, time. When did that trouble started? Time factor. I am reporting this thing, yesterday's report, or maybe 1 month before, or maybe 6 months before, or maybe 20 years before. The historians may write a report which has happened, long, long back. So time is a very important factor which has to be taken care of when you're writing the report. In this model, they also talk about the location, where. The fifth W stands for where, location of the problem about which you are reporting. And then the last, but not the least, very important aspect, how to report. There are standard formats for writing the reports. We'll be talking about that in the second session on aspects of report writing. But then every organization has its own format. In the absence of the format, your report may or may not serve the purpose. So how to report is also a very important aspect. If you take care of these five W's and one H, you will not go wrong in writing the report. So it is a very important model, which is being followed in every organization. They have their own styles of writing the report. I will be talking now the characteristics of a good report. What are the characteristics of a good report? Number one is precision. Very clear about the exact purpose of the report. Very precisely. Do not beat about the bush. Do not bring the textbooks. I have seen many reports where the students try to bring, reproduce the whole chapters in the report in order to increase the volume. Just now I have mentioned brevity is the soul of communication. So let it be very precisely, clearly, in a very brief manner written. Then accuracy of facts, we have talked about that. If you are sometimes tempted to manipulate your results in order to satisfy or please your boss, this is not a very good idea. It has to be, even if the things may not match what it should be, let it be accurately presented, that the accuracy of facts is a very important thing. Whatever the facts are, present it unbiased and without any play in that. Then relevance. Whatever is relevant to that report, only that much. I always say that lengthy reports diverge in. Nobody reads them. Whatever is irrelevant should be eliminated from the report. Then it should be reader-oriented. Know that in any communication, your target audience is very important. Just now we have discussed who are the people involved, the writer, the reader, and the third party. You must know who is going to read my report. Accordingly, your language, your presentation, and everything in the report will be varying. And it should be facilitating the reader. If the report has to be read by vice chancellor of a university, or maybe the head of the department, or maybe your professor, or maybe somebody in the industry. So accordingly, the language and the facts will be presented in the same manner. Let it be reader-oriented. Let there be proper flow in the report. The flow should not be compromised. Just because you have so much of data, sometimes you have a tendency to put all the data in the main body of the report. We'll be talking in details in the second session of this topic. Then objectivity of recommendation. Your recommendations are the future work which has to be done, or based on whatever your findings are, what actions are required. And there should be objectivity in that. Without objectivity, the report is again a waste of time and energy. It should be impartial and very well objective. It should be having simple and unambiguous language. Just to impress the reader by using jargons or very difficult words will not be a good idea. Let it be very simple, unambiguous, grammatically accurate language should be used in report, both in oral as well as in, especially in the written reports. Then grammatically accurate. If you are grammatically making mistakes, this also distracts the reader. He is not actually focusing on the contents, that what are the contents. He will start focusing on what kind of mistakes you have made grammatically or spelling errors. So this will distract the reader from the contents of the report. Then clarity, proper arrangements of the facts, the sequencing or the systematic presentation of the facts is a very important thing. Then define your sources very clearly. Write short paragraphs. As far as possible, write in the bulleted form that number 1 point, number 2 point, or the point, give the bullets there, and then it will become more and more reader-oriented. Then I have mentioned already the brevity. The brevity is the soul of communication. I am repeating it again and again because many students make a mistake when they write the report. They feel that the marks will be awarded based on the volumes they have written. Volumes is not important, but then the contents, your presentation, your analytical work which you have done there, the inferences, the discussions which you have included in your report are more important than the volume of the report. I know of a student of Ohio University in USA. He presented his PhD thesis in 14 pages, 1-4. Can you imagine the amount of brevity he has exercised? He was doing a research in the hydraulics, and his PhD thesis was in 14 pages. And the persons who came to evaluate, they said that 3 PhDs could be awarded based on the work which he has presented in 14 pages, 1-4 pages. This is just an example to show you to make importance of brevity in your report writing also. Then preparing, how to prepare for a report, investigating the sources of information. It can be primary source, it can be secondary or tertiary sources. Investigate the sources of the information which you are going to present in your report. Then taking notes, what you want to present in the report out of the total information. Then analyzing the data. Then making an outline. Now, this is very important point. The fourth point is very important. You have done the work. You have the data with you, maybe primary, secondary, or tertiary sources. Many times you feel struck where to begin and where to end. You keep on postponing it. I always recommend that you try to make an outline of what you want to present. That should be a good beginning. Once you have made an outline, do not worry about, you may change the structure, you may change whatever you want to include or not include when you are writing the report, but writing an outline is a very important aspect. What happens is when without writing the outline, if you start writing the report, number one, you will be delaying. Number two, you will not be able to contain all the things which you want to do or present in a report if you have not made the outlines of the report already. Then writing the report itself. These are the steps for writing the report. How to collect the data? Just a few lines on that. Direct personal assessment. You may be yourself conducting the experiment. You may be yourself have collected the data through various means, tools, questionnaires, and other things. Maybe you have interviews, you have interviewed the people and those are recorded. This can be another method of collecting the data. Or maybe through correspondence. You have not personally interviewed, not personally went there and collected data, but through correspondence also. Maybe through secondary or tertiary sources. And then questionnaires is another source of collecting the data. Then meetings. maybe you have attended certain meetings. Based on the outcomes, based on the discussions taking place in the meetings, you have the data available with you, which you want to present to the people in the form of a report. Let me give a recap to whatever we have covered up to now. We have covered the meaning of the report, types of report, essentials of report writing, 5 W's and 1 H model of report writing, characteristics of a good report. Thank you very much, my dear friends. We'll be continuing with the format of a good report and certain format for lab report and progress reports in the next session. Thank you so much.